Hi everyone, welcome back. This is Joe. Today we are going to pick up with Power BI and I'm going to show you how to use the map visual. So if you've been following along, open up your DSBB folder and then this Power BI Python file. And if you haven't been following along, highly encourage you to subscribe and head back to the beginning. I have a video on how to install Power BI, and if you're just interested in Power BI, there's a playlist dedicated just to that. There's also a Python one out there if you want to learn how we did the first part of this. You'll see it on the first tab. So go ahead and open this up and then I'll get right to the map visual. As this opens, you'll see this enable script visuals. Just go ahead and enable that. If you haven't been following along and you do have Power BI installed, you shouldn't see anything pop up. You'll just have an empty page one. But if you have the page one, let's just start out by renaming this. You can double click. Let's call it chart underscore practice. And then we can make a new page and we'll call this map practice. So obviously you need a data set that has locations to use the map visual, and that's why we've turned our attention to this LEDF mean that we imported last time using Python. We have entity and life expectancy, so pretty simple. First, let's go over to this pane and let's find the map visual. So I'm going to go ahead and click it. Don't worry if your visualizations pane looks a little different. As I said, Microsoft releases new versions of Power BI just about every month. So you can find the map visual just by scrolling over it. So you'll see filled map, map, and it probably does look something like this. So once you have that, go ahead and resize. And if you see an error, something about security, what you have to do, it'll probably tell you exactly what to do, but go to File and Options and Settings, Options. And then under your global settings, you'll see a security option on the ribbon here. So click security and then make sure your ArcGIS and map and filled map visuals, especially because those are the two we're using, make sure these are checked. And under preview features, you can also go ahead and check the map visuals if you're interested in using some of those. But if you don't see any of these or you're already fully up to date with all of your preview features enabled, don't worry, but either way, once you're done, click OK. You may need to restart Power BI. So if that's the case, pause the video, close out the application, and then open it back up. Save before you do that, and then you should be here. You should see the map visual without any errors. So you can resize it, and then it's pretty simple from here. Obviously, we have this LEDF mean dataset that we pulled in the last time through Python. We just have entity and life expectancy. So you obviously need a location to use the map visual. Lucky for us, we have entities already here and good to go. So we can put those under location. And if you scroll down a little bit, you don't want latitude or longitude in this case, just size, and our life expectancy could be the size. So click the caret though, and again, make this average. It won't matter, but what we're actually after here is the average life expectancy. The sum doesn't really make sense. It won't matter because there's only one entity, so the sum and the average are the same. However, I'm in favor of just avoiding this altogether and doing a measure. So if you right click LEDF mean, do new measure, and explicitly write, I want to write a measure for the average life expectancy. You'll never get confused, and you can also do other calculations on, you know, whatever your number fields are in the data set that you bring in. So you might have more complicated data sets than this in the future. So average life expectancy, I'm doing it all underscores between the words, and it's a pretty easy calc, just average, and then start typing life expectancy. You can do it on the whole column in your data set. Close parentheses and enter, and from here now, instead of doing this average life expectancy, and another point too is it's unformatted, it's just doing the average, so it's giving you a bunch of numbers. Nice thing with the measures, you can format them individually. So I'm going to go ahead and replace size with the measure, which you'll see a little calculator here. And I'm not going to make a new table for just my measures in this case because it's only one. This is pretty much the only one that we're going to do right now, but maybe in future videos we'll isolate the calcs, which is good practice. You'll see that this is still unformatted, but as long as I'm selected on the measure here, I can go up under measure tools, and then I can just click the comma here. This will make it two decimal places. You can also change it to one or three or whatever. Now when you hover over, you'll see that the tooltips only have two decimals. So this is looking good, and I'm just going to change a few things, like preference things. So under map settings, I'll do an aerial map. I like the way this one looks a little better. And we can do category labels, just toggle that to on if you want to see exactly what country next to the bubble. And that's all I'm going to change for right now. You could see how easy it is to create the map visual, and you could visually see by size exactly what's going on here. If you hold in control and hit the scroll bar, you can zoom and drag it around, so you can see that Russia has a pretty low life expectancy as compared to the United Kingdom, and the United States is roughly the same as the United Kingdom, only separated by about a year. So I'm just gonna save work from here, and we'll pick up again with some more advanced measures in the next one. So stay tuned and hope to see you there. Take care.